you all for coming. This is a great crowd. So the pieces I'm going to be playing today, the first one is called Valsiana. It's by a composer named Sergio Assad. He wrote it in 1986. It was actually the first solo work he ever wrote for the guitar. I'll be playing the second movement of a three-movement work called Aquarelle. It was inspired by his wife, who liked to do a lot of watercolor paintings. And this piece sort of sounds like if Debussy was a Brazilian guitar player living in the 1980s. It's just really, really pretty, and I think it has the greatest last chord in any guitar piece ever, so you can tell me if I'm wrong. The second piece I'll be playing is called The Cathedral. It's by Augustin Barrios. He wrote it when he was inspired by the San Jose Cathedral in Montenegro. Or Montevideo, I forget which one it was. I think Montevideo. Sorry, my bad. And it was originally a two movement work, with the first movement being sort of inspired by Bach and kind of hearing the organ pieces that were being played in the cathedral at the time. And the third movement is sort of rapid fire arpeggios and long passages that sort of describe the chaotic nature of leaving the spiritual solace of the cathedral and kind of jumping out into the street at the time. And then 18 years later, he went back and rewrote the first movement, which is a prelude about reflection, sort of nostalgia at his time in the church and writing the piece. So I hope you enjoy.
Thank you. Hi, everyone. So I'm going to play two sets for you. The first set is two pieces by J.S. Bach. There we go. So I'm going to play two sets for you. The first is two pieces by J.S. Bach. It's a prelude and fugue from his prelude, fugue, and allegro. This is an amazing piece of music. Just a little bit about the prelude and fugue format. The prelude is kind of like a contemplative, improvisatory piece that comes before a more serious piece, like a fugue. And the fugue is a contrapuntal study on a short motive. And I'm going to explain that in a minute. So he chose a very short melody, and then he embellishes that melody over a long period of time with different musical figures. So here's his subject. I'm just going to play it for you really fast. Thank you.
We come to our basket passing time, and as always, we're very, very deeply grateful for anything that you could put in the baskets as they come around. And likewise, we are continually grateful for the support from our friends at Cuyahoga Arts and Culture, at the Ohio Arts Council, the National Endowment for the Arts, and of course, from Trinity Cathedral. So thank you, and again, our thanks for your support both by being here and by in the form of anything you can put in the baskets as they come by. Looking ahead, we've got the listings for all of the spring concerts on the back of your program today. A week from today is Ash Wednesday, the beginning of Lent. So we won't have a concert a week from today. And there are services here at Trinity at 7:30 a.m., at noon, and choral service with the choir at 6 p.m. a week from today to start the season of Lent. Then 2 weeks from today, we are back in business and we have a nice long run of concerts. Through March, we're having four programs celebrating music of the 60s. How about that? How many of us were alive in the 1960s? Now be honest, be honest. Yeah, yeah, yeah. How many of us were young in the 1960s? No, we won't ask that. We won't ask that question. Young is open to a lot of interpretation, isn't it? You know, anything under 50 is pretty young nowadays, I think. That's what Joe says anyway. Yeah, so music of the 60s, viewed from different vantage points and different types of, different styles of music, different performers. We start on the first Wednesday in March with one of our BrownBag favorite performers, soprano Christine Cashwell. And Christine has a really terrific program of songs from musicals in the 60s, and you can cast your mind back over that. There's a really rich treasure trove to pull from in that area. So that to look forward to, and then the first week in April, which is actually April 1st, we have a really thrilling program of organ and brass quintet music. We haven't had an organ and brass program in some years here at the BrownBag, so we thought it was time to do that. It'll be brass quintet from the Blue Water Chamber Orchestra, and myself strumming along at the organ, and we planned out the program the other day. It's going to be a real thriller, so plan to be here for that. So those things to look forward to, and I think that's about all we need to talk about. And I think that the baskets have been already very efficiently passed, so we're ready to move on, and please give a very warm welcome to Alejandro Rodriguez.
So the first piece that I'm going to play is by it's a ballet by composer Manuel Maria Ponce. He's a Mexican composer, and that's one of the reasons why I started learning more of his repertoire. I'm from Mexico City, and usually his repertoire is pretty complicated to play, so I was waiting a little bit until I felt a little more ready. But this piece, it's really nice. I love the bass line here. If you try it and like listen to the bass, it's got a really nice line there. It moves kind of constantly, but it keeps you interested. And as a ballet piece, I'm sure you know a ballet dancer would be able to stage a choreography on top of this, so it's something you can think about there. And then the fantasia. Fantasias were composed to sound a bit virtuosic, and so you'll hear almost a drastic cut between sections. So you'll hear very clearly the difference between these sections, and it's gonna be moving fast. You might even imagine an opera singer singing this because it's about the time where bel canto opera, which means beautiful singing, was very popular at this time. So that's another thing to think about. Thank you very much, and I hope you enjoy it. This piece that we're about to play is by Brazilian composer Heitor Villa-Lobos, and of course you're going to get a nice groove here by a Brazilian composer, right? This is called Lenda do Cabo. I don't know if I'm pronouncing it right, I don't speak Portuguese. But caboclo is a term for someone that's born of Brazilian and, mixture of Brazilian and European. And it's worth mentioning that Villa-Lobos was, he was trained classically, but he included a lot of European ideas into Brazilian, into his compositions, as well as folk Brazilian rhythms. And so here we see a mixture of tango, which as we both of you don't know, is well, you're gonna hear that in this piece, as well as other elements from Brazilian